Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another trigonometric substitution problem today. This one was sent to us through the website, and the problem is dx over the square root of 81 minus 9x squared. So as with any trigonometric substitution problem, we have quite a bit of legwork to do before we actually get started. The first thing we need to do is identify u and a. U, remember, represents the variable part of whatever's inside our square root here. So it's going to be the square root of 9x squared, which is 3x. And then a represents here the square root of the constant. So that's going to be 9. So we identify u and a. Then we look to see what our trigonometric substitution will be. Because this represents a and this represents u, we have, right, this is a squared minus u squared. So if we look at our reference here, a squared minus u squared, the substitution we're going to be using is u equals a sine of theta. So then we go ahead and plug in u and a to this, and we get 3x equals 9 sine theta. And then still several more things we need to do before we get started. We need to solve for x. So we'll get x equals, divide both sides by 3. 9 over 3 is 3 sine theta. We'll need to find dx. The derivative of sine of theta is cosine of theta. So dx is going to be 3 cosine theta d theta. We also need to find, we need to solve for sine of theta. So we divide by both sides by 3 and we get sine of theta equals x over 3. And then the last thing we need to do is solve for theta, which we do by raising both sides to the base sine to the negative 1, which will cancel out the sine on the left, and we'll be left with sine to the negative 1 of x over 3 on the right. So quite a bit of legwork, like I said. You need to identify which trigonometric substitution it is, solve for u and a, come up with this substitution here, solve for x, solve for dx, solve for theta, and solve for the trigonometric identity, sine of theta. And then, last thing we need to do is draw out our reference triangle. So, which we always do like this, we put theta here, and because sine is opposite over hypotenuse, and we solve for sine here, opposite over hypotenuse, we will have, let's see, opposite, which is x over hypotenuse, which is 3. So we have opposite over hypotenuse. And I'm actually worried, I think it's going to be the same thing, but if we solve this for sine of theta, right, sine of theta equals, we would get 3x over 9, and it would be 3x over 9 for opposite over hypotenuse, which I feel like is safer because it's the actual values that we pulled out for u and a, and it's supposed to be u opposite and a hypotenuse. I don't think it will make a difference, but make sure you're using your original values, u and a. U should be opposite, and a should be hypotenuse. And then, using our reference triangle for substitution, u equals a sine theta, adjacent is going to be the square root of a squared minus u squared, which is exactly this over here. So it's the square root of 81 minus 9x squared is our adjacent side. So now that we're all set up, we can actually do the problem. So the problem, we'll start substituting. So we solve for dx. We got 3 cosine of theta, and then we can put our d theta out here. And then we solve for x, so we're going to plug in for x, and we get 81 minus 9 times, let's see, we said x was 3 sine theta, so 3 sine theta, And then, of course, that is squared, so we can't forget to square that. And now we can start simplifying. So we'll have the integral of 3 cosine theta over the square root of 81 minus, 3 sine of theta squared will be 9 sine squared theta. So when we multiply that by 9, we'll get 81 sine squared theta d theta. Then we can factor out, let's put this over here, we can factor out, 3 cosine theta over, factor out the 81 inside the radical, so 81 times 1 minus sine squared theta d theta. So then we can actually break this apart, and we'll have the square root of 81. Since these are multiplied together, we can break them apart. Square root of 81 times the square root of 1 minus sine squared theta. So if we have the square root of 81 out here, that's the same thing as 9 out in front. So we have 3 over 9, so that's 1/3. So we can pull 1/3 out in front of the integral. And then we'll have cosine of theta over 1 minus sine squared theta. Because we're using a squared minus u squared, we are using the identity for substitution when we get to this point. 1 minus sine squared theta is the same as, so 1 minus sine squared theta is the same as cosine squared theta. So, equals cosine squared theta. So, we'll have the square root of cosine squared theta, which we plug in for this 1 minus sine squared theta. The square root of cosine squared theta is just cosine of theta. So now we have cosine theta over cosine theta, so they'll cancel, and we'll get basically just 1, right? So we get the integral of d theta, which is just going to be theta. So let's give us some space. So our integral is going to end up being 1/3 times theta plus c, which when we plug back in for theta, which we solved for over here, we will get a final answer of 1/3 times sine to the negative 1 of x over 3 plus c for the constant. And that's going to be your final answer. So hope that helped, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!